Good morning.
Good morning.
Am I on? Happy Mother's Day. Will you please stand for the call to worship? We gather together to worship our loving, nurturing God. Knows us intimately, loves us unconditionally, teaches us the way we should go, and comforts us in times of need. Praise God, the source and sustainer of life. We've come to worship God who loved us before we were yet born.
He knows us even better than we know ourselves.
His presence never leaves us.
His love for us.
This is our God.
Let us worship together.
Let us pray. Good and gracious God, we greet you on this spring day honoring mothers and graduates. The day is yours. The night is also yours. You have prepared the light and the sun, given us summer and winter. We follow the seasons of spring as we anticipate the summer and the blessings of warm summer days. Looking around, we see all signs of your presence in the sky, the trees, the flowers, and in the people we love. We bow to your amazing creation and love, knowing that even the dreariest days cannot last forever. God, we ask that you help us hold the vision of a better world and our role in making it happen. Praise and adoration to you, Father, for your eternal presence. Hear us as we affirm the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy
kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Becky, you may be seated. Becky will share a special song with us.
Good morning. I'm going to do something a little bit different today. First of all, I have a poem. Does anybody, do you remember the Ideal magazines?
Yeah.
This was my grandmother's. And there's a poem in here that's called God Knows. God knew we needed a guiding hand, a loving heart to understand. When all the world was strange and new, for babies don't know what to do. That's why he made mothers. God knew we needed a lullaby, a soothing voice if we should cry. Two listening ears if we should wake, a kiss to heal each childish ache. God knew we'd need a gentle touch, much more than a friend's, yes, twice as much, to make and keep us ever strong when we were tempted to do wrong. God knew we'd need a place to rest, the solace of a mother's breast, the hope that she alone can give, her blessing every hour we live. God knew we'd need a mother's smile, two eyes to guard us all the while, two arms to comfort and to care, a love that no one else could share. God knew we'd need her help to walk, her eyes to teach us how to talk, her faith to follow day and night, her prayers to give us second sight. God knew we'd need her patient way, her loyalty day after day. God knew we'd need her love to teach the human things his hands can't reach. That's why he made mothers. That's why he made mothers. Let's see if I can make it through the next part. This song, Mother, when I was looking for my copy of it, and I knew I had a copy of it, this is what I found. And this song was written in 1915. I think this has been around since 1915, but anyway, it was kind of, I go around to at auctions and I lots of times will buy all their old music. But the one I am going to use, same words and everything, but it's newer, smaller. Okay, now the next thing is too, that when we get to the chorus, the words are going to come up on the screen, and I'd like you to sing it with me. Some of you probably know the song. Some of you really younger ones probably never heard it before. But let's sing it together when we get to the chorus. Okay.
Supposed to be so slow, would fail if they were called upon a simple word to spell. Now, if you'd like to put me to a test, there's one dear name that I can spell the best.
Mother's Day.
Good morning and welcome to our Sunday worship service. The flowers on the altar are given by Lynn Messersmith in honor of Steve's birthday. We're excited to hold VBS this year. The dates will be July 19th through the 23rd. 9 o'clock to 11:30 a.m. Participant ages are kindergarten through fourth grade. And we need lots of help. So if you can help in one of the following areas, we would be excited to have you on the VBS team. Here's what we need. Prayer, the key to everything. 4 station leaders, adults 18 to 100 years old. See, nobody's eliminated. And junior or senior in high school. 8 guides. They've completed fifth grade through age 100. Sound and video technician and photographer. This is probably the easiest and most fun job of the week. So if you would like to fill your morning with VBS fun, laughter, and time with Jesus, call or text Annette 308-760-7755. The Alliance United Methodist Church is accepting applications for the position of Director of Ministries. The person will work closely with the pastor and other ministry leaders, coordinate children, youth, and outreach ministries, help strengthen the spiritual life of the congregation through relationships, nurturing, caregiving, and providing resources to committees, small groups, and individuals. Applications can be picked up at the church office and will be accepted until the position is filled. Trustees will meet this Tuesday, May 11th at 7 o'clock p.m. in room 202. Faith Circle will meet on Wednesday, May 12th at 9 o'clock a.m. in Fellowship Hall. If you have any prayer requests or concerns, call the church office or message us on our Facebook page. If you wish to give online, please see our Facebook page and click the Shop Now button. If you have any questions, feel free to call Renita at the church. Wednesday night devotional is every Wednesday at 6 o'clock p.m. through Zoom. Renita sends out a link for it every week. If you wish to join, please contact Renita to be put on the email list. The worship committee is planning a special Memorial Day Sunday, May 30th. Please, if you have someone who has served or is serving in the military, please send a picture in uniform to Renita digitally. If you're not sure how to do this, give Renita a call at the church.
We have a few prayer requests. I'd like to have continued safe travel for Gideon and others who are traveling at this time. And we want to lift up the graduates as they embark on this new phase of their life, this new chapter. We also ask for prayers for Chance Smith, who was involved in a horrible accident and is recovering now at the hospital from an amputation. Millie says praises for Roger's good results from their procedure. So let's be in an attitude of prayer. Dear Lord, on days when all seems to go wrong, help us to remember you are always nearby to give comfort. Remind us that no matter what, you are there for us. We ask your presence with those who struggle with fear and anxiety. Heal their anxious thoughts and give them peace. Lord, I ask you to bless and comfort all who daily see pain and desperation. Bless the doctors and nurses working with seriously ill and the caretakers toiling through the days of sickness. Let each one of us be a comfort to someone we know who is in need. Guide us toward those we can be of service to, reaching out to the ones who feel they cannot go alone. Send your comfort, Lord, to those who grieve. Love them with compassion for their pain. We pray always for the poor and displaced in our world. Bring them ease. And Lord, guide our church family, this community, and our nation to be true Christian beacons in the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Carrie.
Our scriptural reading for today is from John chapter 19, verses 25 through 27. Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother there and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to her, "Woman, here is your son." And to the disciple, "Here is your mother." From that time on, this disciple took her into his home.
Would the children please come forward for children's time?
Morning. What is today?
Mother's Day.
Mother's Day.
And we're going to celebrate our moms who take such good care of us. What does your mom do to take care of you? What does your mom do for you? Nothing? Everyone shy this morning?
Feed you food?
Okay. Did your mom take care of the house? Help you with homework?
My mom helps me with my homework.
Yeah, lots of things, huh? And are you guys doing anything special for your moms today?
Yeah, Mother's Day.
Maybe going out to lunch, going to help her around the house. Did anyone give their mom a present this morning?
We.
Okay, who is Jesus' mom?
Mary.
Mary, that's right. And Mary took care of Jesus just like our moms take care of us. Our scripture today said he entrusted his mom to his disciple. He wanted her to have a family and be taken care of when he was gone. Family is important even when you're grown, and we're lucky to have mothers or other people who act like mothers to do things for us. Okay, let's pray. Dear God, thank you for our moms. Help us to care for them like Jesus cared for his mom. Not just today, but every day. Amen.
Would you please stand as we sing our next hymn, which is The Gift of Love.
I have tried all morning to get someone to trade places with me. And so far, Leanne is the only one who said she would. Pastor Gideon had texted me and said, "You need a Mother's Day sermon." And I said, "But I gave my Mother's Day sermon last year. What do I do this year?" He said, "Just get up there and tell them how neat mothers are." I said, "That's like you getting up here and saying how neat preachers are." So as I thought and prayed about all of this, I wondered if maybe there was something that we could learn from mothers in the Bible. Tom from Uncle Tom's Cabin says, "The Lord gives us many things again and again, but he don't give you a mother but once." And today is the day that's set aside to pay tribute to mothers. And I know that we as mothers think that our job is probably tougher than anything else that we would have to do in life. And I think we are probably right. We're living in the worst of times to raise a family. Drugs, violence, all kinds of temptations pulling at children. But the mothers in our scripture today had some very difficult choices to make during their critical time. And so I think that mothers have to be all things at all times. The first mother I thought about was Jesus' mother. Jesus is on the cross, and you can see the love of Jesus. Here he is, he's dying, gasping for breath, and he sees his mother, Mary,
who has comforted him all through his childhood, who has kissed the bruises and the cuts. And I'm sure that when he was a boy, he would run to mom and be in her loving arms. But now he sees her at the foot of the cross, heartbroken, crying, and his heart goes out to her. And rather than being concerned for his own welfare, he is concerned about his mother. She will soon be a widow. She will be known as the mother of a crucified criminal. Life will not be easy. She's witnessed her eldest son put to death in a time where the loss of the elder son made losing everything, home, security, provisions. As she stood at the cross, there were shouts of ugly insults, and his sword pierced his side. I cannot even imagine the pain of watching. This is her son. She knew he was without sin, but she stood and witnessed his death with grace and courage. And I wonder what we could learn from Jesus' mother. And I thought, what are mothers? Well, mothers are teachers. Mothers are disciplinarians. Mothers are cleaning ladies, gardeners, mowers of lawn. Mothers are nurses and doctors, psychologists, counselors, chauffeurs, coaches. Mothers are developers of personalities, molders of vocabularies, shapers of attitudes. Mothers are the soft voice saying, I love you. And mothers are a link to God, a child's first impression of God's love comes from mom. Mothers are all of these things and much more. And I found an example of who a mother is, and it's explained in this story. It said a second grade teacher had been giving a lesson on magnets. And she explained about them and showed them how they would pick up nails and bits of iron and things. So came time for questions, and she said, my name begins with M and I pick up things. What am I? And the little boy in the front row said, mother. Being a difficult time, the choices for mothers are not easy. The mother of Moses had a difficult choice to make. The Hebrews had fallen into slavery down in Egypt. And as they began to multiply and grow stronger in the land, they became a threat to the Pharaoh. And he commanded that all the baby boys be killed, thrown into the Nile River. The book of Acts tells us that many parents abandoned their babies. Maybe not abandoning them to die, but that hoping that someone would come along and save their life. And verse 18 says, there was another king who became ruler of Egypt. He dealt with our people and oppressed our forefathers by throwing out their newborn babies so they would die. Moses' mother tried to make a better decision. It says, first of all, she hid him for 3 months. Can you imagine the fear that she must have had? praying and praying that no one would hear this baby crying. That someone from Pharaoh's court would not come by at that time and discover that baby and take him. Moses' mother had a difficult decision when she could hide him no longer. She put him in a basket that day and put the basket out in the river. I don't know how she could do that except with God's help. The Old Testament account gives you mom's confidence, maybe. Confidence, maybe, that you can handle today's situations. Moses' mother, with God's help, did the best that she could. None of us have ever had to make that kind of a decision concerning our children. But there are other painful decisions that have to be made. There are difficult medical decisions that have to be made. Sometimes those decisions may mean life or death. We need help on a daily basis from God. Too many of us are trying to do it on our own. We make decisions that are difficult without the guidance of God. And we wonder why things don't work out and why our prayers haven't been answered. There is no parenting manual that gives all the answers to tell the right way to handle everything. Moses' mother was not an expert in any way, but she sought the Lord's guidance on a daily basis. Moses' mother knew she couldn't shelter Moses for a long time. He was going out of her protection. He was on the Nile River where dangers existed. He was going to grow bigger and stronger every day. But her help came from her prayers and handling the situation that day. And then there was Hannah. Hannah was childless for many, many years, but she prayed and prayed that God would give her a child. And she said she promised God that if he gave her a son, she would give him to the Lord. She prayed for his birth and made that promise that if she was rewarded a son, she would consecrate her son to God. So when he was about three, she took him and left him with Eli, the priest, for training. Once a year, the family went back for the yearly sacrifice. And every year, Hannah took a robe, a blue robe that she had made for him. A robe that she had put love into every stitch. And when she left the house of the Lord at Shiloh, she said, I have lent him to the Lord. I don't believe that there's anyone who thinks that she stopped praying for him just because he was being trained for the Lord. I am certain that she prayed for her prophet's son as long as she lived. Are you praying for your children? Are you praying for God's direction in their lives? That doesn't just mean moms, grandmas, aunts, cousins. All of us. Bathsheba was the mother of Solomon, who was an extremely human wisdom. He was one of the most knowledgeable that we read about. And I know that God gave him wisdom beyond the normal human being. But I also believe he had a mother who gave him good advice, who raised him knowing God. Salome was the mother of James and John. Some think that she is the sister of Mary, the mother of Jesus. In any way, she and her sons were very close to Jesus. She was a very ambitious woman. She wanted the best for her sons. So during Jesus' ministry, she asked him, "Grant that these two sons of mine, one can sit on your right hand and the other and left in your kingdom." So moms, stepmoms, grandmothers, others who are involved in the caregiving, it requires wisdom from God to be a good parent, a good mother. All of you, if you depend upon God to guide you and direct you, we need that help during the difficult times as well as daily decisions. And as I thought about the qualities and the responsibilities of mom, today, it's no wonder that it's a special day, because we know that a mother's love is probably the closest thing to God's love that we will ever have. It's a love that goes through the valley of the shadow of death to bring life into being. It's a love that sacrifices itself over and over again and would lay down her life for her child. Mother's Day is not only for your moms. It's aunts, grandmas, cousins, sisters, wives, and fathers. I know fathers who have had to be mother and father both. The dictionary defines a mother as all who perform the role of bearing some relation to someone who may or may not be their biological offspring. So this is meant for all mothers. Working mothers, housewives, married mothers, single mothers, those with money, those without, and for those who love without limits. So let's reach out to our moms today. Remind them how much they are loved and how appreciated they are. And let's honor and celebrate them. And in conclusion, I would like for you to bow your heads as I pray for our moms. Dear God, thank you for your endless provisions of faith, of grace, and mercy. We come to you today to lift up every person who answers to the name of mom. We ask that you supply each one with the strength that they need for the difficult days. Give them wisdom when to know to encourage and when to correct their children. Supply them with an extra dose of patience. Remind them that children are a heritage and a reward. They are cherished children from a loving father. We pray for contentment in this very special calling. May every mom realize that this is a mission from you, one that will bring truly great rewards in the end. We ask this in your precious and holy name. Amen.
Our closing hymn will be a video, One Heartbeat at a Time.
All night with a screaming baby, you run all day at the speed of life, and every day you feel a little bit less like the beautiful moment you are. So you fall in bed when you run out of hours, and you wonder if anything worth telling got done. Maybe you just don't know, or maybe you forgot. You are changing the world, one little heartbeat at a time, making history with every touch and every smile. Oh, you cannot see it now, but I believe that time will tell how you are changing the world, one little heartbeat at a time. I know you can do it. Every tear that you kiss away, so many little things that seem to go unnoticed, they're just like the drops of rain over time. They become a river, and you are changing the world, at a time, making history with every touch and every smile on you. You may not see it now, but I believe that time will tell how you change in the world, one little heartbeat at a time. You are changing the world, one little heartbeat at a time, making history with every touch and every smile on you. You may not see it now, but I believe that time will tell you changing the world. Oh, I believe that you are changing the world, one little heartbeat at a time. You're changing the world.
Beautiful tribute to our mothers. Would you please stand for the benediction?
I pray as you leave this sanctuary that you remember you are changing the world, but you have to have God's help. Go with his peace and love. And tell Mom how much you love her or how much you miss her. Amen.